So I have to admit that I don't actually watch Fox News, but I see it, excerpts from it on the Twitter feed. So I got a little bit curious, like, what is maintaining that thing, and looks like Disney made some deal to purchase Fox. But it apparently didn't include the news outlet, so the quote-unquote news outlet continues, and it's in a physical place, so they're headquartered in New York, in some portion of the Rockefeller Center, which appears to be managed by a global real estate firm, a pretentious Canadian firm. Ivanhoe. And so I reached out to them and pointed out, hey, maybe it's not the best idea to be, working at Fox News given they're a known propagandist for the Republican Party, masquerading as a news outlet. And so they, kind of snootily responded that they don't. They're a global real estate entity and they don't engage in political debate. So, and I figured, oh, well, who owns that place? And it appears that there's three entities, and one of, Rockefeller Center is going to own its global hideous things. And one of them is Mitsubishi Estate. So, and I looked at their balance sheet and they've got a shitload of money. So, anyway, so, there's no obvious way to communicate with whatever that is in Mitsubishi Estate. There is a person that's positioned at the top of that structure. What he exactly does is not immediately evident. But, so, it would be interesting to, engage with those entities and make the argument that historically it's not going to work out so well if they continue to enable propaganda that benefits, I guess it's corporate fascism. I don't know, so it's basically corporate fascism. And some weird nationality stuff like the Zionist fascist corporate people that want, if they go to this magical place, they'll be rewarded in the afterlife. So, there you go.